The purpose of this video is to help people looking at cancer reports understand what cancer statistics mean and how to use them in health planning and priority setting. First Nations, Inuit, and Métis planners, policymakers, and healthcare staff can refer to it when they're looking at cancer statistics for their populations and communities. It was developed with the help of people from First Nations, Inuit, and Métis organizations and other groups who are concerned with cancer in First Nations, Inuit, and Métis communities. Together, these groups have generously given guidance to Cancer Care Ontario's Aboriginal Cancer Control Unit staff about what works when trying to explain cancer numbers. This presentation will include an introduction to cancer risk, an explanation of how we compare cancer in different populations, four important ways of measuring cancer in groups of people, and some of the methods we use to collect cancer information in Ontario. Viewers can watch the whole presentation in one sitting or go directly to any of these individual topics. Let's imagine all these dots represent a group of people or a population. A population doesn't necessarily mean the population of a whole country. It just means the group of people we're looking at, such as members of a community, people who do a certain job, or a group of patients who are part of a cancer study. At any time in a population, most people will not have cancer. Looking at a group of 1,000 people, we would only see a few cancer cases. If we zoom in on a few people in our population diagnosed with cancer, we'll see different types of cancer. Some cancers, such as the one represented by the red dots, are more common than others. Other cancers are very rare, and years might go by before anyone gets this type of cancer in a specific population. The causes of each type of cancer are sometimes very different, and how we treat each type of cancer is different. Some cancers are more serious because they spread more easily or quickly. These differences mean that everyone's cancer experience is unique. A cancer risk factor is something that people do, a condition they have, or something they're exposed to that increases their chances of getting cancer later in life. Some cancer risk factors are things that we have no control over, such as age and sex. The older we get, the higher our risk of cancer gets because our cells lose the ability to repair damage over time. Other risk factors are things we may be able to change, such as smoking or drinking alcohol. Other things we can do to lower our chances of getting cancer later in life include keeping a healthy body weight and eating lots of fruits and vegetables. Some cancer risk factors are things that we're exposed to in the environment, such as ultraviolet or UV radiation from the sun, which is linked to skin cancer. There are also cancer risk factors in the environment that people might be exposed to in their homes or communities simply by breathing indoor and outdoor air, eating, drinking, or doing their job. Screening is a way of testing for early signs of cancer or finding cells that are not normal and could become cancer in the future. When cancer is caught early, before it spreads to other parts of the body, it's easier to treat. There are screening programs in Ontario for breast, colorectal, and cervical cancer. Breast screening is done with a type of X-ray called a mammogram, which checks for breast lumps. Colorectal screening is done with a home test that checks for signs of blood in the stool. Cervical screening is done with a Pap test, which checks for early signs of cervical cancer or cell changes that could become cancer in the future if they aren't treated. Here's an example using marbles that is a great way to understand cancer risk factors. Say we have a jar full of marbles. Some are black and some are white. You have to reach into the jar and pull out a marble. A black marble means you get cancer. We can think of exposure to cancer risk factors as adding more black marbles to the jar. Even a heavy smoker might pull out a white marble and stay healthy, as many of us know lifelong smokers who have not had lung cancer. But if we compare a heavy smoker's jar to a jar of a non-smoker with mostly white marbles, we see that the smoker's chances of pulling out a black marble are much higher.